Yeah, so what I'm trying to get you to think of is you're initiating here instead of here. So in my head, the bar is not going to come up at all. I'm just going to pull myself underneath. And then going on.
Like if you do it, if you get the arms right and you don't have a full grip, mobility, at some point, you should end up hitting yourself in the throat so hard you knock the wind out of yourself because you won't control it, but everything's just going to be moving.
Yeah.
And not a fun thing to go through, but it's an easy thing for me to see, okay, we're progressing and doing that.
It's amazing how many elites go to fingertips. Like a lot of them, you know, not being reset.
So that comes down to one of the teaching things too, is the difference between the Chinese are big on that, right? You see them in the fingertips with their elbows here. But their back isn't here, back here. So they're still tight in the upper back, but they're here. And for most people, that nuance here is better, especially when you're learning, because the elbows up and out and the back has to be tight. Here, it doesn't have to be. If it doesn't have to be, it won't be when people are learning.
Straps now.
Yeah, I would take the straps off now and just
I still have my thumb around the bar. I'm not hooked, but I can see it's still around there.
So the big point of contact to the catch. That amount of time, just listen.
Game.
That works.
It's crazy how like a lot of like elite CrossFitters or elite weightlifters, they went gymnastics and then obviously sports, and then they went into probably the CrossFit.
Men weightlifting.
Or they went into weightlifting and then went into CrossFit. Then like the volume of work.
Yeah.
Back to weightlifting.
Yeah. Go for it. My goal is to improve somebody's numbers with the least amount of work possible. That's the goal. It's not how much can you do. I mean, yeah, there are certainly times, and Anna jokes about it, and she just says, she's like, yeah, sometimes I think you program like this because you can't hit your kids, so you're going to punish us. It's the variety. That's I like. The only thing I do high volume is I'll do it every couple of years with athletes where I put them on a 20 rep squat program. More for the brain than anything.
It's more like making you tough because if you can squeeze out 5 more than you thought you could.
Yep.
Something up here changes.
Yeah.
It's like I thought that was hard, but I had more.
Yep. Teaching people what their actual limits are is a tough one too.
Nobody knows what their limits are, especially fitness.
No, I know. I mean, I always go back to bike racing. It came down to who could suffer more. And that's why I was good at it. I learned to suffer and then to play it off. I mean, one of my favorites was sitting at the front of a pack riding almost 30 miles an hour, cracking jokes, pretending it was easy, and then attacking. I was fucking toast. But nobody followed. They were scared to.
Yeah, they thought you were crazy.
Yeah.